Welcome to Real French Food. I'm Olivia Saez, and I'm going to show you how to do a weekly planner using one dish. You can step it up as you get used to doing this and planning out and maybe do two dishes and then have it last all week, but we're going to do just one. And don't worry, we're making meatloaf. It's not grandma's meatloaf. Trust me, this is going to be really good. We're going to use turkey, and we're going to use some really healthy, very simple ingredients. We're going to make this all in one bowl, and then we're gonna pop it in the oven, roast it, and then it's gonna last you for the rest of the week. So let's get started on doing that. We have about a pound of ground turkey. Super lean, really good for you, really not a lot of fat, so it's really perfect meat for you. We're gonna take about a tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. I'm sure a lot of you at home really mess that up every time, don't know how to say it. It's Worcestershire sauce, okay? About a tablespoon of that, we're gonna put it right on our turkey. A teaspoon of minced garlic. And if you have the fresh garlic clove, that's better. The stuff that's already in the jar actually loses a lot of its potency over time. Even though it's sitting in oil and things like that, you do lose its potency, so try to get the fresh stuff. It's the best stuff for you. I have about 2 tablespoons of a chopped onion. You can coarsely chop it, finely chop it, you know, whatever you prefer. Definitely put it in there raw because as you cook your meatloaf, the onions are going to cook too and soften up. You're putting this in the oven for a good 45 minutes, so your onions will really cook through. We're going to take an egg, fabulous egg, and we'll put the whole thing right into our meat there. And now is when your hands are going to get dirty, so please don't be afraid, okay? Just put your hands right in there. It's not going to hurt you. You're not shoving your hand in your mouth with raw meat. It's fine. Just let the ingredients really mesh together. Okay, so we're gonna take a loaf pan. So we're just lining our pan with some cholesterol-free oil, okay? It's really low cholesterol, really good flavorless oil. And we're just gonna put our turkey into the pan. And we're just gonna flatten it out just so that we don't have any loose pockets. Now, ordinary recipes have ketchup, which has high fructose corn syrup. What is that? It's fake. It's not real food. Don't eat that stuff. Ketchup is good once in a while. I love it. Don't get me wrong. French fries, weakness sometimes. But on a daily basis, not good for you. So what we're going to do instead of ketchup is use an actual fresh tomato. And we're just going to slice it up. Using a serrated knife is your best bet. That's how you're going to cut through your tough tomato skin and really just have perfect slices of tomato. And all of the juices from the tomato, you want to retain that as much as possible because this liquid is actually what's going to keep everything moist. So we're just going to overlap our tomatoes a little bit. And on top of everything, it just makes it look pretty. It's fun to display it like that. And then we'll take our last bit of tomato here, our last little slice, and we're just going to cover as much of the meat as I can. This way you've got lots of moisture that's gonna just hang out, and you've got that extra tomato flavor. So I'm gonna put this in a 400 degree oven for about 30 to 45 minutes. Everybody's oven is different, so keep an eye on it. You just want the meat to cook through. So if you wanna keep it a little bit longer, that's fine. If it tends to be a little bit dry, we're not gonna use any kind of fattening sauce with butter and things like that. We're just going to enjoy it the way it is, and I'll show you how to do that so that you can plan it for the entire week. Okay, so while that's gonna be cooking for about 30 to 45 minutes, I actually have one that I've already prepared so I can show you how to make this last for the whole week. I've let this cool as well, and we're just gonna go ahead and we're gonna slice it. So it's actually, it looks pretty cool, right? I mean, it's, the tomatoes are all on top, it's in one piece. I mean, it looks pretty nice. I mean, you could technically arrange it on a plate, but I know this is what freaks us all out. It's like, oh God, meatloaf, it's fine, you guys. I mean, it's really actually pretty good. So we're going to slice it so it doesn't look anything like what you normally would see meatloaf to be. So you could do thicker slices, thinner slices, whichever you feel in the mood for. Our first night of the week, we'll have this straight. You pop this thing right out of the oven. It's going to be nice and hot. You can put it on a plate with some vegetables. If you really absolutely have to have a sauce, you can do a béarnaise sauce is really good. It's a little bit citrusy. It'll go really nicely with that. Not too many calories. You can keep it really simple, a little shallot, some white wine. You can put that right on your meatloaf and you've got a nice little meatloaf dinner. But some other alternatives that you can do, one of my favorites is to make an actual sandwich. So, you know, you've got a nice piece of bread here. I've got a really nice ciabatta roll, and you can just put the slices right on the bread. I love adding a nice piece of brie or another kind of low-fat cheese. Not too much, don't overdo it. That's where the fat comes in. So just a couple pieces just for the flavor. I absolutely love truffle oil, so I'm gonna sprinkle a little truffle oil on here too. It's gonna be an amazing sandwich. Some extra tomato if you want, a little bit of lettuce, any other kind of vegetable that you might have in your fridge, and you're good to go with a nice sandwich for lunch. Another fun option to do, I've got a pasta here. We can do a bolognese sauce with this meatloaf. So you can take a couple slices, and while you're making your sauce, you can just chop it up really fine, just like that. And then make little tiny pieces as well. And then mix that in. Let me look, it's just like you have ground turkey. And you just mix that, either put it right on top if you want, nice and hot, or you can just cook it in your sauce, and then that way the tomato sauce just oozes right into your meatloaf. You have no idea this is meatloaf. I bet you won't even notice. Another fun option, choose something different. I love using black rice. Black rice is super good. It has all of the nutrition that you could get from something like quinoa or a different kind of ingredient, and it doesn't cost you nearly as much. So, and it's different. It's different color. It's just super cool to use. So you can do a nice dish with the black rice as well. If you want to heat up the meatloaf, do a different shape, chop it up, have it right on your rice, have it next to it. I mean, you have a different dish. So using your ingredient, main ingredient, throughout the week is a really great way to keep it simple, have a weekly meal planned out, and as you feel more comfortable planning this stuff, you could do two different recipes. So one night you can do a meatloaf, another night you can do salmon, and then use that salmon in a few different items. You can make chili and have a nice piece of salmon in there. You can do the same type of thing, make a sandwich, do a plate of pasta. Really use as much as you can, use your pantry staples and as many ingredients as you possibly can so that you can last all week long. So enjoy this meatloaf, don't be afraid of it, it's super good. It's a nice classic American dish, turned a little bit French. So à votre santé.